There you are, in the middle of the night. You cannot sleep. You realize it's your old friend knocking. The feeling of existential dread has enveloped you once again. Why this time, you ask? Well, who knows? Maybe it's a recent setback in life, or your state of isolation and loneliness, or even the realization of the fleeting nature of time and inevitable death. The cause matters not. What's important is that you are here. For this is not a bad feeling. This is an opportunity. You have probably watched many good videos about existential dread already. So let me warn you. I am too dumb and numb to fully understand what the philosophers have to say about this. I find it difficult to comprehend their claims in any actionable way. So I will not try to explain what I don't fully understand myself. What I can do, however, is present the way I see it and the tools I use to deal with it. To me, existential dread, in its basic form, arises from simply asking why. Why do we have to wake up every day? We go to work, eat, sleep, in a pointless cycle. Why are we plucked from the blissful inner awareness of sleep in the first place? Some would say it is to find God or to find the beauty in life. Well, life might be beautiful, yes, but you know what is more beautiful? The void. Remember how we've been questioning our existence for the past millions of years before we were born? Yeah, neither do I. As for God, well, the short answer is that it wouldn't work. The long answer is a subject for another video. The question is then, why not end it? Why not embrace the void, right here, right now? That is the most important question, isn't it? As Albert Camus puts it, there is but only one serious philosophical problem. And that is suicide. Judging whether life is or is not worth living amounts to answering the fundamental question of philosophy. You see, the root of the problem is that we long for an inherent value and meaning to life itself, but we are met with a disappointing silence and utter indifference from the world. This is what Camus refers to as the absurd, and he exemplifies the cyclic pointlessness of life in the story of Sisyphus. Sisyphus was a king who was punished by the gods for his rebellious nature. For all eternity, he was to roll a boulder up a mountain, only to have it roll back down to the bottom when he reaches the top. This mimics our lives. Every morning, we wake up, we push our metaphorical boulder up that metaphorical mountain, only to see it go down by the end of the day. We perform tasks of absolute futility and meaninglessness in the grand scheme of things. And we are stuck there, with no way out, except, maybe, jumping off that mountain. Yet, Camus argues that there is another way. When the boulder rolls back down and Sisyphus follows it, he says, "I see that man going back down towards the torment of which he will never know the end. That hour, which returns as surely as his suffering, that is the hour of consciousness. At each of those moments when he leaves the heights, he is superior to his fate. He is stronger than his rock." Sisyphus does not hope that it will stop, because it never will. He does not start wishful thinking or finding other distractions to forget his suffering. On the contrary, he understands and accepts the absurdity of the situation. Understanding this does not bring a feeling of despair. It brings a feeling of revolt. The revolt is the certainty of a crushing fate, without the resignation that ought to accompany it. It is indeed a hopeless situation. First, life is a game that we are forced to play without prior consent. Nobody chooses to live, we just exist. Second, this game is pointless, but we are hardwired to search for meaning and fear death. So opting out is not really an easy option. Given this absurd predicament, my answer to why I do not off myself right now is that I accept to play the game. I am going to complain about it the whole time, but I will play it, and I will play it with my rules. Existential dread no longer brings despair, it brings anger. And in this context, suicide feels more like cheating at the game. The struggle itself towards the heights is enough to fill a man's heart. One must imagine Sisyphus happy. Or in this case, angry. So, the idea here is to mine the anger stemming from existential dread as a source of energy, and use this energy to push the boulder, to be stronger than our rock to revolt against the absurd. But every revolt or rebellion needs at least three elements. First, an objective. Second, a strategy. Third, logistics. Defining these elements and the tools I use to support them is the subject of the next video. Till then, stay angry, do not cheat, be superior to your fate, stronger than your rock.